What's up, guys? We're here with Lcans versus Mazar. This is really funny because I just uploaded a PS Live and I had like four of the same mons that Lcans has. Let me just rewatch the first turn really quick. That would gang over with Formosa. Scar Formosa, I assume. Mazar. I don't know why I said Mazari earlier. I guess because he's spelled with a Y there. But yeah, his Smogon name doesn't have that. Okay, that's. Is it AV Magierna? I'm not sure. Depends on the Gengar set. Did he go for Flashcan? Okay, he just went for Flashcan. That did a ton to the Landorus. There's another Gen 7 game going on. Let me like check if that is for SBL as well. No, I think this one is the only one for SBL going on. That's nice. I hate recording two battles at the same time. Yeah, okay, fine. This is the only one for SBL at the moment. I mean, there's a Gen 1 game, but I don't really care about Gen 1. Or I don't have the knowledge about Gen 1 to bring that content. What day Bagheera will be pegging Ice Beam? I don't think so. Okay, maybe if this team is like specifically weak to Spadef Gliscor. Doesn't... Like, this is probably Rock's Bronzong on this team and then Double Dance or Scarf Lando. But I assume it's like... Zemo Landorus. Okay, he just U-turns. Okay, really nice play there, staying in. Because he had Almamola and Landorus in the back. He just knew he wouldn't go for Earthquake, I guess. I mean, Bronzong eats it up, but he can Vault out. So, it might be AV Magearna, but that shell will... a decent chunk, so I'm not sure. That shell ball from Gengar earlier. So he's probably just gonna bring out his Zard here. Let me just close my my rendering program real quick, cause that makes the computer laggy if it's opened. With rendering Blunder's match. God, what is this annoying lag? Yeah, he just goes Zard and he could be. I'm thinking he's Zard X, but he could be either Zard. Because, like, Formosa is not the most reliable hazard control, so Zard X would make a bit more sense to me, because that only takes 25 from Stealth Rocks. I mean, Fiend is always a good mid ground play, I guess. Okay, this is Zard X. And he goes for Wisp. Ooh. I don't know about the Wisp play. He predicted the Landorus, I assume. But I don't know about the Wisp play when there's a Feeny. But I'm not trying to bash you, my dude. Yeah, like Brando said, this set seems horrible in Sun and Moon. Yeah, I don't know about that set actually, because like Feeny is everywhere. Ooh, predicts him not to go for Wish there, goes for Moonblast, because the taunt was so obvious, that's why he went for Moonblast. I assume the Mola is gonna go for Protect. Good god, this nickname. This nickname. I'm not gonna translate that for you guys. That Moonblast actually did a ton, so maybe it's like Fist of Mola. Not sure. Why is Alamola taking damage? So I get to kill this thing. Actually, if this is Zardwai, dude, I have four of the same mons on my team then. I just uploaded live with Zardwai. Oh, it's Zardex, okay. So this works out for Mazar. He's probably defensive Rocks Lando. Makes the aggressive play of rocking. Like, I would make this type of play on the ladder, go for Rocks on Zard, and then they would stay in, because they already have a DD up, and they are like, nah, nah, we set up already, we're not switching. And then I would get punished, and they would tweet key on me with Flablets. I mean, they are saying what a god in the chat, just threw them up, no respect. But if you make that play on the ladder, you will get punished, I swear. But this is SPL, so I guess he read his opponent well. Yeah, Bronzong should get rapid spin. Yeah, that's true. But Bronzong already has, like... You kind of want to have Earthquake, HPS, Gyro Ball, Rocks. So you don't really have space for running rapid spin. I guess he could get rid of Gyro Ball, potentially. I don't get why he flash cannon there, but was he predicting like the Lando or something? I mean, this is nice for Mazar, or Mazar, however you pronounce him, because he can like throw up a witch here. You already get left rid of the lefties on the Feeny, which is also pretty nice for him. Because if he gets rid of the Feeny, he can like potentially spam Will-O-Wisp with his Zard later on. If Mr. Turin is gone. But the Feeny is still really healthy. I don't think this Will-O would have Toxic. The last move is probably Scald. Toxic would be interesting, no Scald. Okay, just goes Lando, that was the obvious safe play. Mazar will probably just go for U-turn here. I don't see a reason for Lcans to stay in, exactly. So, I guess he's trying to get some chip with Helmet Tangrowth. No, okay, he's AV Tangrowth, okay. I mean, AV Tangrowth... Like, Type of Feeny already checks Ash Ninja, but I guess you can never have enough checks for that monster. Like, I have the same core on my team. I like this core to Angus Feeny. And then have the Bronzong in the back to check Double Dance Landris. Is he gonna go for Shadow Ball here? Okay, he just goes for Psy Shock. But yeah, the Bronzong is already really low. Like, this is the most obvious Alamomola I've ever seen, so... Lcans might double switch, but the thing is, if he doubles, his Bronzong just gets lower and lower. Because it has to take Rocks again next time. Ooh, it's not Choice Tapu Lele. But he sacks the Lele. I don't know if that crit mattered, but... Like, he just had a free Alamomola there, I don't think... Like, I don't see what he lost from going Alamomola there. Maybe he thought HP Fire would kill. Why does Lcans have a Buck Catcher, dude, as his avatar? So I'm guessing he cocked versus Fistef Bronzong, and this Bronzong had some split death, I'm not sure. But this lost Mazar, his Lele, which is really annoying. Because Lele could have gotten like huge damage on Tangrowth with Psy Shock later on in the game, or on Feeny. Like, this is the most... actually, Magina's at 12%. I thought Magina was healthier. How did the Magina get that low? I didn't pay attention earlier. I think he got Earthquake by the Bronzong. I mean, Zard is a fine play, but Feeny just walls him unless he's like Thunder Punch. Okay, he has Earthquake and he gets a crit, that also works. To chip at the Feeny. I mean, yeah, that works, because the Feeny lost the lefty, so it's not getting anything, like any health back. So yeah, I guess you can just treat Kyoto's Feeny. Landorus might come out here. Actually, Landorus is really low. I don't think Landorus will come out. I thought the Landorus was healthier, so... Okay, he just makes the Earthquake play. I thought he might flare, but still predicting a potential switch. But it's not like he really had a switch yet, because if he goes Zard, he has to risk this being Dragon Claw. And Zod, yeah, Zod also takes super effective damage from Earthquake. Yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about. I think the Alamomola is really fits def since the Moomoo's from Fina did a good chunk, so he doesn't have a switch in. He will probably just sack the Magearna here. Like, he really doesn't have another play in my opinion besides sacking Magearna. Oh, they're talking about if Zod eats. So apparently the Gengar specs, they're saying in the chat, that would make sense if the Magearna was AV, because the Shadow Ball actually did a good chunk earlier. Yeah, this would have to run a lot of Spadef to eat a Shadow Ball or Sludge Wave. Nah, he's not going for Sludge Wave when the Magearna lives rocks. He cannot, if he's choiced, he cannot afford to lock himself in the Sludge Wave. Because that would give the Magearna a free hit on something. So maybe Mazar is calking if his Zard can live this, if he's like really Spadef. And yeah, he just sacks the Magearna as I thought he would. On the Shadow Ball? Yeah, on the Shadow Ball. Exactly, no reason to Sludge Wave with Magearna around. And now he can go into... what was the Scarfer? I guess Famos is a Scarfer. Landris probably lifts the Shadow Ball from full. I mean, after rocks even. I assume it's like 80. But the thing is, the Bronzong is really low. The Bronzong dies to U-turn at that range, so I think Landris is either Landris or Alamomola is the play. Alamomola and go for knockoff also works. Yeah, okay. I thought the Alamomola was lower, but it said 70 here or 77, but it didn't calc in that it got regen, so it's even healthier. Like, this is pretty much a free wish or knockoff. Like, I don't think the Gengar will stay in here, because the Gengar is like really nice. Yeah, exactly, why would he stay in? Yeah. And this is just a free switch. Actually, it's not a free switch on the Zard, because he can go for Earthquake and kill the Zard. I might go for knockoff here if I'm Mazar. I would probably go for knockoff here, because there's no way he goes for Giga Drain here when there's a Zard in the back. And he doesn't want to let him wish up the Zard, so he's probably going to go for Earthquake or something that hits the Zard harder than Giga Drain. But yeah, we should
see. What is good, guys? We are with...
Just finished rendering Anti. Versus Dice in the back, and it just opened the recording. God, why did I lose my words there? Oh, he made the Zard play. I don't think that was the play. Yeah, exactly. That was pretty obvious that he would go for something that hits the Zard. I think he could have just stayed in there and gone for knockoff. But this is pretty easy to say for me, because I'm just watching this. Like, if you're in the position and you're playing, that's obviously a difference. I mean, I get his play. That was kind of a 50-50, but I still probably would have stayed in with Alamomola there. So he's, I think this is called veggies or vegetables in English, this name. He's probably just gonna go for U-turn, and the Tangos can live that though. Like, Lcans might stay in, go for Giga Drain instead, get some damage on the Lando. Like, the only thing he needs is Tangled Forest for the Alamomola, maybe. Yeah, that actually did nothing. Like, Pharamosa's not that strong. Considering this is probably a Solvest Tangled. Yeah, this is a Solvest Tangled. And he's probably just going for Giga Drain. If he goes for HP Ice, he's a god, okay? I thought he went for HP Ice, but it's HP Fire, I think. Okay, I was just clicking on Blunder, see if I missed any other important matches. Okay, U-turn picks off the bronze arm, but pretty sure Lcans wins this. Like, he could have saved his tempo a little earlier and just gone into Mola, and he also could have just stayed in where the Mola was, the bronze zone, but that's easier set when you're just watching, like I already said earlier. So, I don't know if the Gengar can live a hit at 60, at 55 after rocks. Lcans is probably calculating if Gengar can live a hit from Faramosa. Faramosa doesn't get knockoff, I think, so he should be able to live any hit. U-turn is like, I think it's 4 times resisted, don't quote me on that. High jump kick doesn't affect Gengar. What else? This is, okay, Ice Beam is an option. I think Ice Beam also won't kill from there. And then he probably has Rapid Spin to get off health for Hazard. He might have Poison Jab over Ice Beam, but probably has Ice Beam. So yeah, nothing that can kill Gengar, so the Gengar pretty much gets a kill here. Unless the Almola somehow avoids the 2-hit KO from Shadow Ball. The only reason not to go for Sludge Wave is the Landris in the back. But Landris might even get 2-hit KO'd if it's offensive from that range. Yeah, I'm assuming he's calking here because the time is like running lower. Or like, it's not running low, he still has a lot of time. But his time has like... You know what I'm trying to say, right? I just don't have the words for it because my English isn't the best. Like, depends on the... he's probably calculating how much the Almola took versus his Phoenix, so he's typing in his Phoenix spread versus the Almola, so he can like compare that to Gengar versus Almola. And then he finds out if that would shoot KO. Yeah, I don't know why it took so long to bring this out. You can just fire off Shadow Ball. Unless he really wants to make sure to 2-hit KO Almola and go for Sludge Wave. But like, Shadow Ball is just free overall. He doesn't lose anything. I guess it is able, but that disable didn't matter. Last week there was like a match, Cicada was... I think it was Lcans, and Lcans lost to... Ooh, he gets a crit on the Sludge Wave. I mean, that would've 2-hit KO'd, that didn't matter, I think. Pretty sure they would've 2-hit KO'd, and I also think the Landris couldn't have lived 2 Sludge Waves, because it would've been at 61 after rocks. So he couldn't have pivoted even if the animal lived dead. Don't think that crit mattered, but don't quote me on that. So he's trying to bring this in Scarf U-turn range. Probably gonna click U-turn. Oh, it might be an Ice Beam range now. If it's an Ice Beam range, that's good for him, yeah. They're saying it should be physical in the chat, but yeah, like they all want Ice Beam unless you're CBB. Like this could have been easier for Mazar if he didn't say his Lele or Zard earlier, but. Don't want to talk down on him. Like I would misplay a lot if I was in this pressure situation. Like you cannot even say okay it doesn't like Ice Beam. But yeah, Tang with AV, Tang with Eat that up. He can go for HP Fire here. Like I'm not saying he misplayed, but I just feel like he could have played that a little bit better earlier. But what did I achieve? Who am I to say this? Like I'm just a random player. Like I have no achievements in tournaments, so I'm gonna be quiet. So I guess his only hope is to freeze, and he doesn't get the freeze. So yeah, he loses this. Unless he's... No, he's not Scarflander, he already revealed rocks. Scarflander actually cleaned here. With Earthquake, probably. Yeah, he said it himself, he didn't play as well as he should have. It's all good. We will look at the score and see how the score, like, the score for his team. What's going on there? As Lcans is 1-1, I guess it's nice for him to pick up a win. So the score is 1-3 now for the Classiest versus the Circus Maximus Tigers. Okay, that's a bit disappointing to see my German dude lose. I don't know why I called him my dude, I don't know him that well, but I'm still gonna call him my dude. I guess I know him a bit from Deutsches Eck, like group on Showdown. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I feel like it was an okay match. It was pretty enjoyable, like some turns could have been played differently, like we all know this. But it was fine overall. I will see you with more FPL. I think the next match is gonna be PokeAim for Ubers, and that's in like 15 minutes. So stay tuned for that, and peace out, friends. Nah, I think I will probably upload the PokeAim video before this one, so yeah, but stay tuned anyway for more FPL. Peace out.